Hey, and welcome to our virtual open house right here in DeKalb. And I am super excited to be presenting you this one because it has received a lot of updates and upgrades. So let me make sure I'll get my screen shared here with you so you guys can see what I'm about to show you. I'm super excited that you get to see this home that just got listed in DeKalb. How are you guys doing? If you just happen on, let me know you can hear me. Let me know all of this is working fine. And then we're gonna dive right in. We are going to be touring 1529 Lewis Street in DeKalb, Illinois, that just hit the market. Super pumped. So I am presenting it at the steal of the week because it is super priced. It got great updates. So today's home, a great expanded ranch in DeKalb. It does have three bedrooms, one den, a family room, a living room, an updated kitchen, a fenced-in yard, and a two-car garage. Let me ask you this. Why would you still pay rent? And it got like this really cute paint job to outside. Like it looks like a really pretty color. So I want to take you through the house just like any other open house. So if you are missing the open houses due to what, you know, our current circumstances, this is your chance to go house hunting in the most virtual way possible. So let's ask you this question first. Should you buy? And this is really a question I want to address first before we dive into it, because people are once again concerned about the economy. And I can totally understand why, because we are in very unprecedented times. So is it a good idea to buy in today's market? And there's a few facts I do want to talk about. And again, it's a very personal decision for people, but here are a couple of key facts to consider. You need to live somewhere. You need to have a roof over your head somewhere, a roof for yourself, a roof for your family. You need to live somewhere. You will be paying someone money to live there, right? Most of us are not able to live a place free. So you need to pay somebody something. The money you pay will most often pay someone's mortgage. That's just a fact. Someone will be receiving money and most likely if it's not paid off, make a mortgage payment. So it's just a third party that is like inserted into something. So why can it not be your own? And if you think about it, 90% of all millionaires become so through owning real estate. This is a fact that you're more than welcome to research. But again, we're not here for that. We are here to talk about 1529 Lewis Street in DeKalb. So welcome home. If you are from DeKalb, let me know in the comments. From DeKalb, let me know that if you live in Sycamore, let me know that too. I'd love to see where people are tuning in from. If you are local to where our headquarters is in Schaumburg, let me know that. Let me know your town that you're watching from. It's always good to see where people are tuning in from. So 1529 Lewis Street is one of the cutest ranches you are able to find in DeKalb. And if you are walking in through the front door right here, as you can see, you have this great foyer. You know, it is not carpeted right here, which is super convenient. If you are walking in and it's muddy outside or it's rainy outside, you're not ruining your carpet. You don't have to have an extra rug. You can just, you know, walk straight in. And then you do have ceiling fans on it. It does have a real nice wood panel and it's brand new carpeting. Brand new carpeting as well as brand new paint throughout. It's been painted throughout the entire home. Okay, so this one is your front room, which is also doubling as your living room. So that is the view from the door, just so you can see it from here. It has lots of light. You do have a big window front. And it's a really, really spacious room. It's a really nice room. From there, we are heading into the eat-in kitchen space. So your eat-in kitchen space is luckily not one of those super cramped ones. It is really having a decent size. And you also have this nice little cutout that the sellers put in, just so you have it a little bit more open, a little bit easier to entertain. So it makes it, you know, really a nice feel of how this property is flowing. So living room, toward this one, and then the eat-in table space or your dining area. This one is the kitchen view. It is a galley kitchen. It does have newer cabinets. They are updated. It's a darker cherry wood, and the faucet's been updated. You have your stove and your fridge on the other side. So there's still a little bit of room that you can also put another like little shelving unit there to just you know, get some groceries there. There's a pantry right there. If you look at this door, it's maybe a little hard to see. I don't think I can point to it. But if you look straight over the burners of the stove, you do see a door right there that could double as a wonderful, wonderful pantry. So that one is really great. And it got a dishwasher. Okay, so there's no scrubbing dishes. It does have a dishwasher. It's fully appliances, and all appliances are coming with it. Now here's the other view from that side. So you do see it right there. Beautiful cabinets. The cabinets are really, really, really pretty. So you see the dishwasher, and then this one walks straight through to the family room, and we'll get that one there next. Now, let's answer one of the big questions, right? Because I don't think I've talked about it yet. How much is it? And the short answer, I do have to be honest, is it depends. It depends on multiple factors, your down payment, all of that good stuff. But for the scenario, for the virtual open house, I personally love to walk you guys through on a scenario of like, what if I don't have a down payment saved up? Because sometimes, you know, you dip into your savings and all of a sudden you don't have 20% down, and that's okay. So my example always tends to be from the lowest end possible, just to make sure I can really show that to the biggest, you know, buyer pool out there. So you can see this house might actually work for you. So if you saw the description, you saw that I said this house can be yours for, and I put a really, really crazy number there. This number is not crazy though. So let me tell you why. The home is listed at $119,000, close to $120,000. So what if you're able to put down 3%? There are loan scenarios out there with as little as 3% down. That down payment would be $3,597. Okay, so if you look into it from a renting perspective, what do you have to pay if you pay rent? You have to fork over the first month's rent. Let's say it's $1,200, and you have to pay security deposit, which is typically 1 to 2 months rent, so $1,200 to $2,400, which now we are at the down payment amount. So when I hear people say, well, I don't have money saved up, that's okay, because there's really ways for us to distribute things. So what if you say, I don't have $3,600? Well, that's okay too. The way real estate works is a really interesting thing, because you can have something that we call seller concession, as long as, you know, the offer is presented right. And this is why it's really important you have somebody that is representing you that knows what they're talking about. We can ask for seller concessions that then are covering a lot of those things. And you're going to see a testimonial later. So if you bear with me, I'll show you a testimonial for one of our clients that he walked away at closing with a check of $2,500. Swear to God, I was next to him and he got that check. But I'll walk you through that too. So you have seller concessions that could cover potentially what you are needing to put down. This would then let you cover the amount you need, so you don't have to have $3,600 anymore. And then what about your monthly mortgage? Because, you know, you don't put that much money down. How much could your mortgage be? So at 3% down, your estimated monthly mortgage would come out to $919 a month for this ranch home. This is everything. We're talking taxes, we're talking principal, we're talking interest, and we're talking insurance. So those are all the four things that should be in that estimate. So if I see estimates on Zillow saying, hey, your mortgage payment is $300 for, you know, that size home, I can tell you they are not giving you the honest truth answer. I don't know about you, but if I see numbers like this, I'm just very, you know, thrown off, because I love to have the honest answer when I go shopping. I don't want to go retail shopping and buy myself a new pair of pants just to be told, well, it says 15, but it's actually not 15. I'm actually going to charge you 30. It would feel like a ripoff. So who's with me on this? So when you are looking at, you know, what is it that it's really worth, you have everything included in this number. This is not a BS number, guys, okay? So I want to make this very, very clear, because I am in the field. This is what I do for a living. And giving people the BS number that they need to pay every month is not how a successful business is ever going to get more people. So I want to be upfront. This is your all-in number at 3% down, $3,600 for a down payment. Your estimated monthly mortgage payment would come out to $919 a month. Please tell me that you can find something like this, a three bedroom for rent for $919. I looked and I know there's nothing. Okay. I looked and there's nothing on the market. So talk about some of the pros before we head back into the property to see some more of the other things. Let's talk about it. What is it that really is the benefit of the homeownership? Now, yes, it's yours. Let's start there. You are talking about the location. This is your location. You get to choose where this location is. So if you know the house I'm presenting you today, you're like, you know, this might not be the one. Even though I think it's a really great house, maybe you have another one where you're like, this is perfect because it's where I want to be. You have stability. How many times have you heard people say, oh, I have to move, my landlord is selling the property? How many times have you heard, oh, I need to find a different place because my landlord is raising the rent? There's no predictability. There's no stability with it. So one perk of homeownership is just the fact that you are able to have more stability and more predictability. Okay. And of course, it's increasing value. Okay. It is real estate. It's not going away. We cannot make more land. So you want to definitely consider that. But back to the property, because I know your time is valuable, so I want to make sure I get to finish touring through the house. This one, if you remember, through the kitchen, we're going to the family room. And the family room right here used to have a wood-burning stove. So if you are, you know, the biggest fan of it, it's all still there. You can get another wood-burning stove. You can hook it up. It's all still there. If you are saying, you know what, this is maybe you don't want one, I'd love to see a Christmas tree on there, right? It's like the perfect little display to just have like a Christmas tree on display. Or like I said, it's meant for the wood burning stove, but feel free to be creative with that part. From there, everything, like I said, brand new carpet, brand new paint, it's all done. So let's get from a different angle. You see it here, there's this little extension that goes right there. And it's another great way for you to just have this big open space that you can use to just distribute, you know, all your members of your family and make sure everybody has rooms. That's the nice part about the expanded ranch. You don't just have this one little area that everybody needs to, you know, huddle against and watch television. You have so many other opportunities to, you know, spread out in your own home. So I personally think it's amazing. So this one is the view kind of from that wood-burning fireplace pedestal. So you see there are the few steps leading up into the kitchen. And then there is a door that leads to the outside patio. Okay. So you have outdoor access straight from the house itself. And then right here where you see my own little self icon right there, by that wall, behind that wall, there is a fourth room. I call it a den. I wouldn't necessarily call it a bedroom just because it is a little bit on the smaller side, but it has so much potential to be, you know, anything you want. If you need an additional pantry space, if you say, you know what, I really need storage space, and I'll show you the room, it's right there. They did take out the closet doors, so it is technically, you could use it as a bedroom if you just have, you know, a futon bed or a bed here, it would fit it. I didn't label it as such, but it is technically a bedroom. You can use it for, you know, storage space, if you needed it for an office space, if you have, you have pets and you'd like to have the dog crates or, you know, cat litter box or something more out of sight. There's like so much space, and it is really a great, great home. So then bottom line, investing in real estate is smart because property is tangible. People always have and always will need shelter. This means it is very unlikely that our need for shelter, for buying or renting home, will ever go away. So if you are wondering about, you know, should I really make the purchase? I can tell you it is not right for everybody. Let me turn off my phone. It's binging. It's not right for everybody just because what if you do know it is a short-term goal that you will be in the area? You know, there are scenarios, and I have the clients that are proving this over and over. Not every scenario is correct for buying. However, 75% of the people I talk to, they are not intending to leave the area. They are, you know, no, we're going to be here for 5 to 10 years. Why not build your own investment? Okay. And this is a statement straight from Kathy Fetke, who is the co-founder and co-CEO of Real Wealth. So she's got a little bit of experience in that sector. Okay. So let's talk about the bedrooms. We are getting into the bedrooms, and then we got the outside left. So the bedrooms, they are a decent size. Like I said, all new carpet, all new paint. It is really, truly an amazing property. So I said, as low as 3% down gets you a mortgage payment of about $919 a month, all in. Okay, so this is your actual number with taxes, insurance, interest, and principal. That's all of that 919 at 3% down. And that number will be lower if you put down more money, if you have the means for it. So then second bedroom right here, again, freshly painted, brand new carpet. It's a really nice light gray that they chose. It's really pretty. And then this one is a third bedroom. They're all a good size. So it's really a beautiful, beautiful home. You don't have any of those popcorn ceilings. They're nice, you know, ceilings. They all have brand new blinds. And then there is the bathroom for the property. Again, super clean. It is a 3-bed, 1-bath. So you do have one bathroom. The toilet is right behind that wall here. You see the toilet paper holder? So it's right behind the shower wall right there. Super clean and really making it a great home. So because buy land, they're not making it anymore, right? By Mark Twain. Let's talk about the outside. So I showed you that little door that we were leading out to. The little door goes straight to the back patio. So you can't see the patio, actually. There's a nice patio area that is really a good size. And then from there, you have a fully fenced in yard. You have a 2-car detached garage. It is matching in color to the house. And you have lots of space, really. If you think about it, the space that you get in this home, and remember, this home is priced at $119,000, okay? So it is for the area and for the space and for the amenities you are getting, an incredible price point. This picture right here, it is the park that is literally just around the bend from Lewis Street. So it is a 2-minute walk, maybe, really right around. It's a great brand new playground that they put in a couple years ago. And then right next to the playground, you do have the field with parking spots. So you have, you know, the option to really be active. And that's just a 2-minute walk straight around the property. And last but not least, Northern University is located in DeKalb. So if you're thinking about, you know, I have somebody that's interested in going to Northern University, I would love to get the in-district tuition. Why not consider buying the home? Because if you look at it from a renting it out perspective, this is definitely a great way to build wealth in real estate, have a place to stay if your child is interested in attending Northern University. If you have, you know, if you want to rent it out to college kids, you can purchase this home and then have it as an investment property. Also possible. or for your own property. This is really so many ways to turn this. It's a great home. So don't wait to buy real estate. Buy real estate and wait. It's one of the most important quotes from Will Rogers that I personally remember even before I got into real estate, that just stuck with me. So I thought I would share it with you right here. So thanks so much for joining. This was really a brief 20-minute walkthrough of the property, 1529 Lewis Street in DeKalb. So if you're wondering what's next, it's simple. If you have more questions, please drop them below. I am going back through the comments. I will answer them as soon as possible. And you can also send me a direct message, or if you want to schedule a showing, feel free to reach out. I'd be happy to accommodate those. And if you have more general questions about homeownership, about, you know, how things work, I'm happy to answer those for you. You can connect with us on our social media, Facebook. It is streaming from my Facebook page, so feel free to follow it and like it. Podcast, we do have our podcast, Real Estate Without the Fluff, where you can get real estate advice in less than 5 minutes. And you can also find us on YouTube for just general homeowner tips. Real quick, meet our team. We are a team of seasoned real estate advisors servicing Illinois. My name is Janine Sasso. I am a realtor and team lead of a Coldwell Banker team. I do work with my wonderful mother-in-law, Janet Sasso, who's our property specialist servicing Illinois, Genevieve Irving, who is our property specialist servicing Missouri, and Mark Ferruzzi, who's also our property specialist servicing Illinois. Here's just a few testimonials of people that have worked with us, just in case you're wondering, like, you know, what was this about? Is this something I can trust? Those are actual people that have bought and sold homes with us, and there is a lot more reviews on it. People that bought, people that sold, people that rented, feel free to verify all of those via Zillow, because this is straight where they came from. I just grabbed four of them. So you can see that we are not just any, you know, scam out there that you see. So I wanted to really show you that we are life people working in Illinois, that you can schedule an appointment with. And here is one of our testimonials.
Zach, for helping us get our house. It went really, really quickly and really, really smooth. We actually got money back from buying the house and didn't have to put anything down, so that was really awesome. It worked out great for our family.
So this one was a VA loan, and we were able to, again, get them money back as well. So, and then there's another testimonial I want to show you before I wrap up here. So here's the next one.
So I'm sitting here at the closing office. Just closed my first home. Got my keys. So Janine was absolutely awesome. She walked me through everything. She got me a nice refund back, so I could go get some new furniture for my home. She was absolutely amazing. We highly recommend her and Zach. Honestly, best buying experience I've ever had. So if you excuse me, I'm going to go move to my new home.
All right. So what do? We are specializing in selling, buying, and investing in real estate. So our job is to really make sure that you are protected 100% of the way. I'm personally with Coldwell Banker Residential Brokerage. I do residential real estate. So there is, you know, nothing that we cannot do fully licensed in Illinois and Missouri. I think the Missouri one is about to be finalized in the next few weeks. Again, there's some ways to get in touch with me. There's my phone number, there's my email, and I'm located personally in Schaumburg, Illinois. So it's a very central location for us to be traveling throughout the Chicagoland area. And that's it. So thank you guys so much. And I'm excited to start your journey. And if you have any other questions, feel free to drop them in below. And I will see you in the next virtual open house.